Senator, in concrete terms, what do those statements mean? Are we going to see joint patrols with Japanese vessels in the high seas, in the West Philippine Sea?
Well, that is a decision made by the Department of National Defense. Mm-hmm. As legislators, we can only support. As a matter of fact, we've already said that we will be increasing the budgets of the Philippine Navy, Philippine Army, as well as the Philippine Coast Guard, as well as the Philippine Air Force. In this year's 2024 budget, you'll see an increase in their budgets for defense spending, as well for modernization of or buying more ships and planes for our armed forces. So when it comes to the policy, I believe Secretary Gilbert Chodoro has not put that off the table. Mm-hmm. He said, why not? Tinatawag po dyan, joint sales. Mm-hmm. It's called joint sales with Australia, joint sales with Japan, joint sales with South Korea. As a matter of fact, I read in the news yesterday, magkakaroon po ng joint training ang South Korea, Japan, and the Philippines next month. Can you imagine that? I think that's the first time na magkakaroon po ng cross-training and training exercises with the navies of Japan and Korea together with the Philippines. So napakaganda po nito. Nagkakaroon po tayo ng multilateral alliances around the region with like-minded nations na naniniwala in the rule of law. Hindi po dictation na lang or dictatorial tendencies and of course, abuse of the rule of law and UNCLOS. So we appreciate that. We welcome it. And if you ask my personal opinion, of course, I'm not the policymaker here, but my personal opinion, why not? Why not? Why not do joint sales with these like-minded countries in these particular areas to assert freedom of navigation and free and open Indo-Pacific?
Senator, the training that you mentioned, the Japanese troops and South Korean troops, is that different from the reciprocal access agreement which we are starting to negotiate now with Japan, which will see trainings, exchanges of troops between Japan and the Philippines?
Actually, matagal na po natin hinihingi po ito, Mike. As a matter of fact, if you look at the earlier, if you Google actually all the news stories about the RAA, Reciprocal Access Agreement, it was our office, my office, myself, who raised this issue a year ago. Mm-hmm. And I said, it's about time that we also come up with more training programs with the Japanese Navy and Coast Guard, as they've been giving us all these ships. They've already delivered, as I mentioned, 12 ships to the Philippine Coast Guard, and they'll be delivering an additional 5. Not to mention the warning radar systems, the warning and control radar systems for the Air Force and the Navy that they've already delivered for the Air Force, and they're now going to deliver next year for the Navy. Mm-hmm. We need their expertise in training for this equipment na galing po sa kanila. And vice versa, so kailangan natin magpadala ng sundalo dun sa Japan para makipag-training sa kanilang Navy and Coast Guard. At kailangan din nilang pumunta dito at makipag-training sa ating mga Coast Guard and Navy units. So definitely a reciprocal access agreement, which is similar to the Visiting Forces Agreement, would be welcome development, because yan po magiging guideline pag may violations. Now, meron pong grupo na natatakot, for example, yung ating mga kaibigan sa kaliwa, they're very scared, no? Natatakot po sila that this might be abused. But between us, Mike, no, and to the Filipino people, isa sa pinakadisiplinadong armed forces, what they call self-defense forces, ang Japanese, mm-hmm. ang mga Hapon. Sila ang pinakadisiplinado, not only armed forces, but they're the most disciplined people, one of the most disciplined people in the world. Eh, linilinis nga nila yung mga stadiums pagkatapos maglaro ang kanilang football team or basketball team. Sila na mismo kusang loob. Linilinis po nila yun, napakatahimik po nila, hindi po sila nang-aabuso. They're one of the most disciplined people in the world, and their armed forces is one of the most disciplined armed forces in the world. I am not worried na magkakaroon po ng violations. And if there will be violations, the RAA will set the guidelines. No? For example, Philippine law will be followed at all times when they're in the Philippines. Pag meron po silang ginawang mali or kasalanan, they will be under the jurisdiction of Philippine law. And same goes for our Filipino troops who will visit Japan for training. Kung meron din po silang nagawa po dyan na violation, Japanese law will also be followed. And so there will be no problems. Hindi po tayo nagbibigay na undue advantage, no, which forgets the rule of law of each country. No, We respect each other's sovereign rights and sovereign laws. And under the RAA, it will only hasten, you know, the entrance of trainers dito sa Philippines and Filipinos to Japan. So napakaganda po nito, Mike, because this will pave the way for a higher strategic alliance with Japan as our friendly neighbor in the north. So I think we should have no problems with that. And looking at our historical past, Mike, mm-hmm. on the Visiting Forces Agreement, I know before it was passed, I believe in the early 2000s, malaki, no? Napaka-ingay ng mga rallies, napaka-laki ng mga rallies noon na aabusuhin po ito ng mga taga-Estados Unidos. I can only recall, and I may be mistaken, but I can only recall two violations of the Visiting Force Agreement. One was an issue of rape, I believe about 18 years ago or 15 years ago, which was settled out of court by the victim herself. She settled it out of court. But of course, nahuli po yung Amerikano, nagkaroon po ng trial, at bago po lumabas ang verdict ng trial, nagkaroon ng settlement out of court. Okay, that's number one. Mm-hmm. Number two, I only believe the second and only violation was the one of Pembleton. Mm-hmm. If you recall, it was a murder of a transgender. Yes. That particular case continued. Natulad po siyang guilty, if you recall, natulad po siya ng guilty, and kinulong po siya. He was under custody and kinulong. And what had happened was, I believe he was transported to the U.S. because there is another treaty that we have wherein prisoners can choose their place of origin where they can continue their conviction, no? Or their sentence. And that's what had happened. So, but natulad po siyang guilty. So there are only two what we say cases or large, what you call high profile cases that had happened. So I would think that with the Japanese, I would think they would be very disciplined and very diligent when it comes to following our rules of law. So I wala po akong problema dyan. And the majority of our members in the Senate feel that it is the right thing to do. And I believe that we can get the numbers for the two-thirds vote for its ratification.
Mm-hmm. And just to be clear on that, Senator, it will have to go through Congress, House and the Senate, or just
no,
the Senate?
No, sir. Mike, under the constitutional provisions, mm-hmm. it's only the Senate. It's the Senate who handles treaties.
For treaty ratification, right.
So, Camila, for treaty ratification, Camila po, we need a two-thirds vote, which is 16 senators.
All right. Senator, let me talk about another topic which is related still to the security in the West Philippine Sea. There's this talk about Senate Bill 2455, the SRDP bill, Self-Reliant Defense Posture Revitalization Act. Tell us very briefly about this bill. What does it seek to establish?
Well, we have, it's called Senate Bill number 2455. The House also has this version. It's the Act Revitalizing Strengthening the Self-Reliant Defense Posture Program. Alam mo, Mike, it's been unfortunate that the last 30 years we saw a steep decline of our ability to manufacture ships for the Navy, ships for the Coast Guard, firearms and ammunition for our armed forces. Nawala po yan. Naalala niyo nung araw, I remember I was a young boy, we had Elisco rifles, which were the M16 rifles that was manufactured in the Philippines, exported throughout. No? We exported it to Thailand. Ginamit po yan ng Thai military. I believe even the South Koreans at the time, when it was still South Korea, North Korea, bumili din po sa atin. It supplied all our military forces with rifles and pistols, etc., etc. So we only realized during the Marawi siege, Mike, mm-hmm. na wala pala tayong, we have what you call, it's the armory in Bataan. And mm-hmm. we saw the armory in Bataan and the Philippine Army armory. At nakita po natin ang kakulangan ng kapabilidad nila to produce bullets, to repair rifles, and they don't anymore have the opportunity to actually build rifles. So mm-hmm. Well, during the Marawi siege, we had to, I remember President Duterte begging Russia, begging China, begging our allies for ammunition, for rifles, for mortar rounds, for howitzer rounds. So it only goes to show that a small little battle like what happened in Marawi is enough to paralyze our armed forces with a lack of equipment and firearms. So we made an active decision, members of the Senate and Congress made an active decision to push for Wishes Pedida, which is the Philippine Defense Development Act, no? Which is to come up with a self-reliant manufacturing capability of this weaponry, ammunition, para dito na po gagawin po sa Pilipinas. And I think that would be one of the great opportunities for us to be able to stand on our own. Kasi sabi nga nila, ba't pa tayo'y naghihintay ng tulong galing sa ibang bansa? I agree with you. That's why we have to push for a self-reliant defense program. Para tayo na po gagawa nitong mga materials na ito na kailangan ng ating Philippine Coast Guard, Philippine Navy, and Philippine Army, as well as our Air Force. Remember that we have the best shipbuilding facilities in Cebu and in Cavite. Uh-huh. Yan po ay proven worldwide that the shipyards in Cavite and in Cebu are building world-class ships, but these are commercial ships. So why don't we build now our ships for the Coast Guard as well as Navy dito na sa Pilipinas? Para sa ganun, number one, workforce, di ba? It will be Filipino local workforce. I will be able to hire more people, thousands of people that will be hired for this program. And we no longer have to ship dollars out. We can now keep foreign exchange within the country and just buy Filipino. So we're actually, sabi nga ni Senator Angara, tatak Filipino to mga kagamitan nito.
Senator,
so
very quickly.
For that, right.
Senator, very quickly. We're talking about how many millions of dollars or millions of pesos here, because I note that in 2022, military-related imports amounted to about $305 million. Our exports only amounted to $85 million. So we're talking about $1 million industry here that we're supposed to develop under this bill.
Oh, you're talking about hundreds of millions of dollars that will be developed once we do it here, Mike. Kasi we're also going to require, there will be an advantage under the law, magkakaroon ng advantage kung ang manufacturer ng mga firearms and equipment na ito will be located in the Philippines, that they will be located here. For example, in the United States, when Beretta won the bid for the U.S. Army pistols, they had to set up shop in Atlanta, Georgia. Mm-hmm. They put up their factory there and built the pistols not in Italy, but in the United States. Mm-hmm. Ganun din po nangyari sa Sig Sauer. So in this case, whether it is locally, it's a local company, like for example, Arms Corps or other local companies within the country who can provide it, or an American or international or European country that want to provide, for example, CZ from Czech Republic, they have to set up shop in the Philippines. They have to put up their manufacturing facilities in the Philippines. So we will be hiring more jobs, more opportunities for Filipinos to work in this industry in the Philippines. So you're talking about hundreds of millions of dollars, billions of pesos of investments in the country that will be able to fund or supply our armed services.
On to another topic, Senator Zubiri. What about the General Appropriations Bill? I understand that it's been forwarded to the Senate. What timeline are we looking at? And also, what's the assurance to the public that the confidential funds that have been realigned to the sectors that deal with security in the West Philippine Sea will not be realigned to the previous departments?
Well, we're going to sponsor the budget, Mike, on Wednesday, November 8th. Mm-hmm. So this week, we're going to meet in caucus about the discussions that have transpired and the amendments that have transpired in the House of Representatives last month. I can't give you of course, if you notice, Mike, kami pong una, ang Senadong una nagsalita tungkol sa confidential intelligence funds na ito.
Right.
As a matter of fact, we were the first ones to come up with the oversight committee, if you recall. Mm-hmm. We came up with the Intelligence Oversight Committee, which I am the chair of. And I believe this week we're going to be coming out with recommendations already on the review, after the review of all these confidential funds of the different government agencies. So, pag-usapan namin dito sa Senado na yun, kung ano po ang parameters ba, kung tanggal talaga lahat or may maiiwan pa, at kung may maiiwan ba, ilalagay ba natin ito sa kanilang MOOE or capital outlay. Now, what is the topic here, Mike? No, the discussion here is on the use of confidential funds. But there is no harm if these funds were actually moved towards the agency's MOOE or line item budget. For example, if they need to hire personnel to constantly monitor a particular situation that is needed for an accurate policy adjustment by their agency, they can do that by, well, we can do that by amending their budget and placing it within the MOOE or the miscellaneous operating expenses, no? So, or their capital outlay, or their under the salary system within the agency. So, at least pagka ganun, hindi na po sa confidential in nature, pwedeng accountable na po yung pondong yan every step of the way. No, dadaan po sa COA yan. So, yan ang pong decisionan po namin itong linggong ito. The best person to ask there, and I would suggest you invite him in the next couple of days, would be Senator Sonny Angara, the chairperson of the Committee on Appropriations in the Senate, chairman of the Committee on Finance. Now, ang plano po natin, when I met with him over the break, ang sabi po niya is he will call for a caucus, and within the caucus, we will decide, no, on that. Whether to scrap it all together as what the House of Representatives has done, and maybe to look at even other agencies, because mayroon pa ibang agencies dyan na may confidential funds, or maybe to scrap only a portion, and the portion can be added to their line item budget, no longer under the confidential intelligence fund. So,
Senator,
these are the options that we will be discussing this week, Mike.
All right. Senator, unfortunately, we don't have much time. Thank you so much. Dagan salamat, Senator Mig Zubiri, Senate President.
Dagan salamat. Good morning to everyone.